My first record, Boney M, Brown Girl in the Ring, things took off for me in terms of listening, Jimi Hendrix and then David Bowie. Music does connect, it's got an emotional punch and power for people in terms of people's lives. They do need music, even if it's everywhere. I'm a computer software engineer, so music signal processing. A lot of bands have done stuff in the studio that they're very proud of. They've layered instruments up together, synthesizers, guitars and things. You come to want to play this live. People tend to press play on backing tracks and play along. The studio is the thing that's going on tour.
I'm in a couple of bands. One's called The Duke Spirit and the other one's Furs. And our single is about to come out off our debut album, which we recorded ourselves at my studio. We started off as a recording band, as a studio band. We were kind of scratching our head, thinking, like, how are we going to adapt this and go and play live now?
You've got pre-recorded backing, parts, things that are integral to your sound. To play in time with those, you have a drummer playing to a click in his headphones so that that technology, a drum machine, a synthesizer, the backing, stays in time with him. He plays to that and then the band follows him. The problem is that he can't actually drive the tempo anymore. If he feels he wants to push it, you know, that option isn't available because you've got to play to this thing that's basically got the musicality of a car alarm. That technology is not responsive to what musicians do.
I play the whole gig to a click track because I'm playing to backing. Really annoying when you want to push things and you've got an energized room and you want to ramp it up a little bit because it's spontaneous and it's the feel. The freedom of doing that, you don't have that with backings.
My work's focused on creating an interactive system to change the tempo of computer sequencing software so it stays in time with the drums. It rides that BPM. You can stretch that backing just to match the tempo that you're currently at. We've set up a microphone on the drums. We analyze it within the software program. That is then sending a tempo to the sequencing software, Ableton Live. Ableton happens to be written as a piece of software that you can constantly change the tempo, and then Ableton is now a slave to his drumming in the room.
What we did here today was a revolution in that I no longer needed a click track because the audio would follow me as opposed to me following the click track. It was liberating, really.
This activity of like doing coding, you're interacting away with a computer system that can do stuff that you can't. So you can start to make things happen that you've got an idea for, and then you see if this thing can do it. When it does it, I guess that's its reward. I think there's a bit of truth in the argument that, you know, computer software engineering, is it really fair to call that engineering? Can you actually fix anything? The counter argument is something like, what was done in electronics, you'd be crazy to do in electronics when you've got a computer now. The mathematician wants a theorem proved. The engineer just wants a solution, dirty solution, however it works. But if this works, is it robust, reliable, does the job? The engineer's happy.